Hello, lovelies. Welcome to test video number one for just an online playful flow. I would like to start sending out videos or giving you the opportunity to work on some of these challenging poses that we do in large classes, but we never have time to break them down. I thought what an amazing opportunity right now to play at home with a little bit of online instruction on how to get into poses like crow, a hurdler, maybe eight angle, headstand. we might have a dog popping in from time to time as well. Headstand or handstand. And just really break those down and get an idea. So we're gonna start with this little test video. My intention is about 15, 20 minutes. We'll see how it goes. But we're just gonna flow a bit, get warmed up together. And then I think today we'll play with crow just to get an idea of how this whole thing is gonna work. As any new challenge, if you've been to my class, you know that I don't move and teach at the same time. So that's gonna be my biggest challenge and my biggest hurdle for this. So please bear with me as I build the strength to do that. And hopefully my words will still resonate with you. And then maybe a little bit of glimpse into my personal practice as well. So I'm all set up, as you can see. I don't know how the volume thing is gonna work yet, but we'll play with that as we go. Again, this is test video number one, so let's get started. Our peak pose is crow. I have two blocks, and if you don't have blocks at home, don't stress. A little stack of books would work very well. The nice thing about the books is you can adjust the height a little bit better, and you don't actually need any props whatsoever. A harder surface will be better for a base for your hands. But again, if that's not an option, you're playing on carpet, it's a little bit more comfortable to fall onto as well. So my biggest tip before we get started is hands, especially in the carpet or softer surface. Make sure your hands are spread really, really wide. So this big high five hand is going to keep your wrists nice and safe, right? There's a lot of tension going through the forearm and hand, keeping the wrists nice and safe. Floppy hands. It's a floppy wrist. There's a lot of pressure there. So even in down dog, a big high five hand, the alternative to that is to pull the fingers together, but still make sure the hand is stiff. So lots of muscles going in there so that we're not putting pressure and dumping into the wrist, but really active through that. So that's number one tip. And aside from that, let's just go ahead and move and play. So go ahead and roll out your mat, get yourself ready, and I will meet you on the mat. Okay, let's go ahead and start off just in a moment of child's pose, just to kind of ground and all have a basis to start. So go ahead and bring your big toes to touch. I like to start by sitting on my heels, spread your knees nice and wide, and melt your body forward. You can reach your arms forward or behind, or if it's a bit tight right now, we can stack the forehead, stack the hands and place the forehead into the hands. And then we'll just take a few deep breaths together. So inhale and exhale. Two more. Inhale. Exhale, eyes closed. Inhale, feel your body expand. And as you exhale this last one, open your mouth and force all of the air out slow and control, and feel your body just melt into the mat and let all of the tension, if just for a split second, melt away. Try to find the space in between the breaths and in between the thoughts and stay there for a moment or two. Start to crawl the arms forward, coming into an active child's pose. Spread the fingers nice and wide. Get a good grip on your mat. Deep inhale, long sigh out. Exhale. And then we're going to tuck the chin around the spine. Come all the way up into a cat-cow. Stretch into the wrist. Lean forward as far as you can. And then walk the knees under the hips, drop the belly, untuck the toes. Inhale for cow pose. Exhale for cat pose. Press into the floor, spread the fingers wide, getting your wrists nice and warmed up to stand on them a little bit later. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cat. And then go ahead and get your head and your tailbone moving in opposite directions, making a nice figure eight into the spine. And if this isn't working in your body, make any other movement that feels good, side body stretch. If you've got that figure eight going, go ahead and swap it, go the other way. Nice head circles, hip circles going in the opposite direction. And then rock forward and back on the wrists, warming up shoulders, maybe pulling your heart through. Just getting into your spine. Swap the wrists around, fingertips towards the knees, and then gently rock forward and back, even peeling the base of the palms up off the mat just a little bit, stretching into the fingertips. Coming forward a little bit more, sitting back. Maybe even giving those fingers a little bit more stretch. Make sure your shoulders are drawing away from your ears here. Inhale forward, exhale back. Awesome. And then just go ahead and flip the hands away while seating back on your heels. Make sure all your weight is in the backs of back towards your heels. And then we're just slowly going to flip the wrists so that the palms face up. Gently bring weight into the wrists, little bits at a time. And then once we get to that point where we've had enough weight forward, go ahead and curl the fingers in, spread them out. See if you can get all 10 fingernails to the mat. Spread them nice and wide, curl them in. Exhale, spread them out. One more time, make the tightest fists you physically can. Exhale, open them up, gently flip them out, and give them a shake. Now that our wrists have a bit of blood flow in there, they might feel a bit tender. That's all right, just getting some extra, maybe reaching them forward. Let's take a nice big inhale. Let's take a side body stretch, reach that right. I guess I don't have to get my rights and lefts mixed up. Left hand reaches down, inhale, breathe into right rib cage, reach up and over, and then we'll go the other way. Nice big full body stretch here. Inhale the other way, sweep up, reach up, press your hips forward, a gentle back bend. Awesome. Let's go ahead and move through a sun A, once or twice together, maybe we add on a little bit, let's see how it goes. Tuck the toes. Come into a forward fold. Gently dangle your head. Soften your knees. Make sure your torso is connected to your thighs. Let the arms just hang. Close your eyes even here. It's a nice way to just get in touch with your body and how you're feeling right now. What areas of your body are creating any tension or holding on. Shift weight into the toes, heels nice and wide. Inhale, half a lift. Exhale, forward fold. Start to walk the hands forward into our first downward facing dog together. Fingers wide, chest moving towards your thighs. Keep the heels lifted just enough so that we can draw the sit bones up high and press the chest towards the thighs. So a little bit of a extended shoulder downward facing dog. And then take the shoulders, wrap them around and pull them down your spine. I'm not sure if you can see that on the video, but we're taking the elbows, pulling them to the back of the room, and then just actively drawing shoulder blades down. So pulling your armpits in. Come high up onto the toes, bend the knees, gaze towards your hands, and slowly start to walk your feet forward one step at a time. Inhale, peel the chest forward, come into a flat back here, connect your hands. If yours don't reach the floor like mine, that's fine. Hands to shins, maybe even to thighs. Just guide the sit bones back a little bit farther, might be nice. Exhale, forward fold, let it go. Tuck the chin, round the spine, inhale. Slowly rise all the way up, draw the shoulders to the ears, a nice big inhale. Exhale, open mouth.
heel-toe, feet-to-touch. Touch.
Let's move through a few warm-ups. Inhale, arms reach all the way up. Connect the palms if you can. Gaze to your thumbs. Exhale, forward fold. Tuck the chin. Inhale, flat back, gaze forward. Exhale, ground the hands. Take your right foot back of the mat. Come into a low lunge just for a moment to get that right hip flexor open. Inhale, heart forward. Exhale, step back, high plank. If you're still working on the strength in your plank, that's perfectly fine. Drop the knees for this first one. Bend the elbows, bring your chest forward. Come into 90 degrees in the elbows. Tuck the toes, inhale, press into the floor. Roll the shoulders up and back, long spine. Exhale, tuck your chin. Roll through into downward facing dog. Deep inhale, long exhale. Notice your heels starting to melt a little bit more in your second downward facing dog. Draw your kneecaps up towards your thighs in a gentle rotation of the femur bones towards each other. One more full inhale. Exhale, empty. Come up onto your toes, bend your knees, look forward. Take your right foot forward, followed by your left. Inhale, half a lift. Exhale, forward fold. Heel, toe, feet together. Bend your knees. Inhale, stand all the way up. Reach up, look up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Let's flow again. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chest forward, flat back. Exhale, let's take the left foot back this time. Come into that low runner's lunge just for a moment to work into that hip flexor left side. Exhale, ground the hands, step back, hard plank. If the knees are not where you want to be and you want to work into your full chaturanga, make sure that you're shifting forward onto your tippy toes here, shoulders drawing back. Exhale, tummy in, bend your elbows 90 degrees halfway down. Make sure your hips are pulling down. Inhale, upward facing dog, roll over the toes. Exhale, tuck your chin, roll through your spine, downward facing dog, hips go up and back. This is that part where getting speaking and moving gets a little bit difficult, but the strength will come like all things with practice. One more full inhale. Exhale, bend your knees. Come up onto your toes. Gaze forward. Left foot comes in between the hands first. Come into that low lunge. Inhale. See if you can keep this right leg straight the entire time. Lift your hips high. Step forward. Half a lift. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, stand up. Reach up. Gaze towards your thumbs. Exhale, hands to heart center. So we'll flow through that one more time. Two on your own, if you would like to pause it, just get into it a little bit more, feel free. I'm gonna take you through one more time without speaking, and then we'll play with a little bit of a crew breakdown. So we're gonna skip Send B for now, for all intents and purposes as a trial video, till I can get my speaking and moving strength up. Inhale, reach up. Go ahead and flow at your own pace. Or pause the video and take your time, get a few extra sun A's in. And when you're ready to come back, go ahead and unpause and we'll meet in downward facing dog. Walk the hands back about halfway into the mat, and then we step the right foot outside of the right hand, left foot outside of the left. Half a lift, wide leg, and then we're going to bend the knees, bring the heels in, toes out, sit bones down, bring bring the hands towards the heart center. So find a prayer squat. And for me, I'm gonna rotate so I can face you from here. Go ahead and stay whichever way on your mat you're facing, but we're gonna work into crow from this pose. So grab your blocks or your props, whatever you have. Go ahead and keep them handy, so if we need them, we can grab them quickly. I'll show you how to get into it without blocks. And then if you do have blocks in your practice or at home available to you, I'll show you how you can use them to help you get deeper. So I like to just kind of give a couple of moments and swing side to side, getting my hips nice and ready in this pose here. And then I'll settle in the middle, hands come to heart, and use your elbows to get your knees nice and wide. Now if this pose right here is quite intense for you and your heels are really high, grab your blocks, place them under your heels, a little added support or your books, or in addition, you can place them under your sit bones so that you can really find length in your spine instead of nice and tall. So we're looking for a hip opener here. Also a good wrist stretch. You want a little added wrist stretch here. I love pointing my prayer down towards the floor and then pulling up. Oh yeah, that's nice in the wrists. Long breaths. Awesome. Let's go ahead and get ourselves back into our prayer squat. And then for a crow, we want to make sure we have those big high five hands. Right, spread your fingers really wide because these are going to be your feet now, your crow feet. We're going to take the elbows, lakwa chaturanga, using that 90 degree elbow. Palm faces really wide down onto the ground. And we're going to take the hands, wrap the elbows back towards the back of the room. Okay, so shoulders pointing forward, elbows pointing back, hands are about shoulder width. And you can see they're inside my thighs. Now, crow one, if this is your very first time flying, take a deep breath. Know that you are only this far from the ground, so a little bit of fall forward, you're going to be okay, especially the fact that you're at home. No one else is in class is going to see you fall, so give it your all here. Spread your fingers wide, wrap your elbows, and then I'm going to use this back of my arm, my tricep, as a shelf for my knee to rest on. And I'm just going to simply start to rock forward onto my tippy toes and rock back. Let's start there. Don't go farther if you're not ready for farther. Shift forward, and you can see my knees are connected to my arms. I'll move it to the side angle as well. Hands spread wide, elbows wrapping in, knees resting on arms, and I'm just shifting weight into my fingertips and back into my feet. So just gentle rocks here and there. Now you'll see the back of my neck stays long, so I don't want to look forward and kink my neck. And also, I'm not sure if you've heard the phrase, where your mind goes, your energy flows. So if I'm looking down between my hands, that's where I'm going. So my gaze is towards, I would say, a good foot in front of your fingertips. So coming forward, looking forward, long spine, and back. Yeah, so step one to flying into crow. Step two, we're just going to tighten our stance a little bit more. Same base of the hands, really wrapping it in. And the more that you can tuck your elbows down onto your shins, the more lift you're going to have as you fly. So what's common in crow is that flat back and leaning and catching your hands. But what I'd like to work on is a little bit of core strength, right? So we're going to pull the navel in and almost round the spine here. So hands come down, I'm going to wrap my elbows once again, and I'm going to find my knees are going to come a little bit closer into my triceps. So just a more tight, compact package. From here, I'm going to come up onto my toes, shift forward, and now I've got a more solid base onto my hands, and maybe I pick up one foot and set it down. And just for play, let's pick up the other foot and set it down. Yeah, so go ahead and pause the video, play with that for a little bit. If you're still uncomfortable being on your hands, grab your blocks or your books, put it at a space to where you can catch your shoulder. So for this one here, I'm going to place my hands just behind that block, wrap my elbows in, round my spine, press out of my shoulders, draw the navel in, and then start to rock forward, and maybe I find my shoulder on that block. What I don't recommend is placing the block on the head. I've seen this happen before. Because then what happens is if you go too far, your block catches your forehead, and we've got a space in which we can't fall comfortably. As important as it is to learn to fly, it's also important to learn to fall. Let's talk about falling out of curl for a minute. So we're new to flying, we've gone too far, we're super excited, the energy's pumping, we push forward, and the knee slips off. And that's how we fall out of curl, right? I'll show you from the other side. Hands come down, feet come up, we get the toes up, and the knee comes off. Super safe. If we land on our face, we're not that far either. I always find it important to fall. Falling finds your edge. Gives you that place of, you know where you can go, right? So it's important to fall that we never find that vital edge. So if we're still playing with curl and want to go a little bit farther, let's go ahead and work into it. Big high five hands. Hits the mat. Wrap your elbows in. Pull your shoulders down your back. So really lock in those shoulders. Around your spine. Come up onto your toes. I always start with straight arms just to get that height and then bend at my elbows as my hinge. Toes come up, toes come up. Pull the navel in around the spine. And if you're feeling strong, go ahead and start to straighten into your arms. Keep your knees drawing up, your elbows, tuck your toes, bring your big toes to tuck. And then exhale, come right out. Whew. Awesome. So let's go ahead and pause if you want to keep playing. We're going to bring it down and ground. It's always important to ground after high energy poses. So let's go ahead and do that now. Find child's pose. And then I'm going to take my fingertips behind just to give my shoulders a break. Bring my head to the mat. Maybe my right temple. Just take nice big belly breaths. Maybe even an exhale out of the mouth. Try the other side. Pull your hands forward. We're going to take one more flow together before we come down. Downward facing dog, we'll start there. Inhale, fully press through your shoulders, press your chest back. See if we can get those heels to melt now. So drop your head, give it a nod and a shake. No tension in the neck. Inhale, come up onto your toes, bend your knees, gaze forward. Find the top of your mat, half a lift. Exhale, fold. Tuck the chin around the spine, reach tall, high mountain pose, gaze up. Exhale, hands to heart. Final vinyasa, inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale for length. Exhale, high plank, low plank. Take your vinyasa. Down dog. Bend your knees, gaze forward, come down to your seat, cross-legged, extend the legs out. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, gentle forward fold. Tuck your chin. If you have a block handy, you want a nice stretch in your spine. Nice full breaths here. Bring your hands below your shoulders, tuck your chin, slowly come all the way up one vertebrae at a time. Just bend your knees, sit bones forward. We'll end in Supta Baddha Konasana. So it's knees wide, because it's not a standard yoga class. We're gonna change it up just a little bit. Give it a nice hip stretch, palms face up. A few breaths right into your belly. Hands outside your knees, draw the knees together, maybe give yourself a nice big hug and a squeeze. Go ahead and roll over to the left side. Use your right hand as a pillow or as a lever and press into the floor, come all the way out. Sit cross-legged. cross-legged for a moment, hands to heart. Hands to third arm. Tapping into self-knowledge, your teacher, yourself, your intuition. Thumbs to lips. Thumbs to heart. I hope you all enjoyed a little bit of playtime. My very first test video for Yoga Fun. Namaste.